Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, I'll be swatching and reviewing the Nykaa Ultra Matte Lipsticks. I have 5 of the shades out of the 10 they have launched, and apparently these are the best selling shades out of the range, and I have been testing them for the last 2-3 weeks now, and today I'm here to give you guys my thoughts onto these lipsticks. So if you'd like to know more about these lipsticks, then please keep on watching. Okay, so first of all, the basic things, the outer packaging as well as the product packaging. The outer packaging comes in this kind of, you know, very replicative of their matte liquid lipstick, but in this time you have to just open it up and in there you get the lipstick. And on the back there is the ingredient list given as well as what the brand is saying about this lipstick. On the packaging it definitely says it's a really matte lipstick. It has a full bodied pigment as well as it is long wearing and it has a weightless formula. And the actual lipstick comes in the same packaging as their So Matte range, their first lipstick range. But in this case, you have a color-coded packaging, a color-coded bottom with the name as well as a number of the lipstick. So that's a really convenient, and of course has the magnetic closure. So yeah, that's about the packaging. And when I talk about the formula is absolutely matte as a matte lipstick can get in a bullet form. So that's a really true claim of extreme matte finish. It also has really great pigmentation. In 1 to 2 swipes, you get a full opacity and also does not feel too heavy onto the lips. So it is definitely a lightweight lipstick and has a full bodied pigmentation. But as much as these are matte, this also comes with a little bit of difficulty. So first of all, I would highly suggest to exfoliate and moisturize your lips 10 minutes prior of putting this on, so that all the moisture from your lip balm is soaked into your lips before you apply this lipstick. Otherwise this lipstick can get a little bit drying. But these are very long wearing lipstick. I have worn this lipstick up to 7-8 hours with minor fading. And of course, like every other lipstick, if you eat oily food, it will definitely come off from the center of the lips. And most of these lipsticks also leave a tint on your lips once it starts to fade away. So the tint remains, and that's why the lipsticks become really long wearing. So if you're someone who likes a matte lipstick but does not like the, you know, filling of the liquid lipstick, then you should definitely check these lipsticks out. Also, another thing that I would like to add in, that when you're applying this lipstick, if you feel like that these lipsticks are tugging onto your lips, which they do if you do not have properly moisturized lips, what you can do is taking your lip balm and dabbing it onto the lips, and then you apply your lipstick, and that way this lipstick will apply a lot more smoother. And now coming on to the best part of this lipstick is the colors of the lipstick itself. So this has this really beautiful 10 shades catering to all the different skin tones, and surprisingly all the shades are some or the other way nude colors. Even if it is not nude, these are really pretty shades. Pretty in a way that we can wear this lipstick every single day without the fear of getting a really strange look from strangers. Except for this, you know, red lipstick. But even this red is a really pretty red. Not too cool tone, not too warm tone. And it is also not like a perfect red red. It has slight touch of coolness to it, but it is not too cool toned, you know what I mean. And this red lipstick is a lot more pretty in this way. Of course, red lipsticks are not for everyone, but I truly like this color. This is the shade Marilyn number 10. That's what I have on my lips. And yeah guys, that is about the review, and now let us see the swatches that you guys have been waiting for.
So let me start with my most loved shade, Diana. It's a beautiful rose shade, perfect for a date night, and moreover, it will suit all the different skin tones. Very gorgeous shade, and I definitely recommend this shade to every one of you guys. Coming up next, another of my favorite shade, Monalisa. It's a beautiful peachy brown color, will suit best on fair medium skin tone. On dusky dark skin tone like mine, it will be more of a peachy nude color, but is still gorgeous. Then comes Nefertiti, a peachy nude color. On fair people, this will be a gorgeous nude shade. On dusky dark people, this will look washed out, but I prefer this with a lip liner, which makes the color a lot more suitable on dusky skin tone, like I'm doing here. So this is with a lip liner and here without a lip liner. See, makes a world of difference. Moving on to more deeper color, Cleopatra. One of the really beautiful wine colors I have seen so far. Perfect blend of red and plum. And this color will of course suit all the different skin tones, and I really like this color. Now last but not the least, Marilyn. She was an icon, so was her red lips. Inspired by Marilyn Monroe, this red is one of the prettiest red I've seen so far. This red color is pretty yet classy, but not so bold that you will get stares, and I really like this color. Let me know which one is your favorite color from the Nykaa Ultra Matte Lipstick range.
So yeah guys, that is about it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, please give this video a like. Do subscribe to my channel if you haven't already yet, and I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.